Deters the Bulldog with you. This is my favorite ELO song on 700 WLW. Got to keep you awake till midnight till the American Truckee Network takes over. Having some fun here. Staff Sergeant Kennedy on a cell phone. You are on 700 WLW.
What's going on, Bulldog?
You're going on.
Hey, you know, all of 08, I was gone to Kuwait and Iraq, and I feel the captain, sir, congratulations for making it back. And,
thank you.
My funeral team, which is the Southwest Ohio team, they did the funeral honors at Fairborn High School. That is where my son goes now, and that was pretty amazing to see all the Patriot Guards, and we had no incident with that church of Kansas City or these clowns that want to.
Have you heard about this, Ray? These are people that are protesting the, thanks, Sergeant, protesting the funerals of military soldiers.
Yeah, I've heard about that. And I understand. I do. I get it, you know, that, and again, there should be limits, I think, you know, but we do live in a nation that a military gives people a right of freedom of speech. And
right.
And I realize all that. Hey, you know, at the same time, you know, I think that I have really got to hand it to the people who are out there honoring and the people that are out there thanking our veterans and our honor guard, you know, speaking
right.
about funerals. Let me
right.
tell you something. I always thank those young airmen. I'm telling you, they would go out and they would stand there in blazing heat, a half hour at least, in position of attention before the ceremony started.
Right.
And I was already sweating getting out of a car, and they'd already been out there for a half hour. And they still stepped up, and they gave a first-class ceremony for whether it was an active duty person in a memorial service or even our retirees, because we
right.
thank God for them.
Right. Tiny on a cell phone, you're on 700 WLW.
Hey, thanks, Bulldog. Hey, thanks a whole lot for your service and all the other military people out there serve. I got a funny little chaplain story. I was in the Air Force.
All right, go ahead.
I was supposed to get married, and we're waiting at the church, and the chaplain never showed up.
What happened?
Well, we gave him a phone call.
Huh?
Underneath his Volkswagen, working on it, forgot all about it.
Randy, did that ever happen to you?
No. I missed a prayer for some banquet one time. I never missed a wedding.
Hey, you ask and you receive. Mark in Springfield, you're on 700 WLW.
How you doing, Eric?
I'm doing good, Mark. I was bragging about you.
How you was?
I was telling Randy how whenever there's a conflict, you've got the right answer. We just nuke them.
That's right. We just nuke them. I want to talk to Captain about something. I'm in Iraq. Did you ever come in contact with the Iraqi soldiers and the policemen? I mean, just the other day in Afghan, policemen shot six Americans. How can you, like, can you talk to them people? Did you?
Well, I did have some contact with, like, Iraqi security forces because they worked with our security forces. But it was rather limited contact. It was pretty much through our security forces. Do we have a chance to talk to them? No, not as much. Our main mission is to the minister, well, wherever there's a need, but we focus primarily on our soldiers, our airmen that are over there.
Yeah, you just couldn't shoot gun poles,
huh? Mark, you gotta love it.
Oh, man.
I gotta ask you, Randy,
because
this is what Mark's wanting to ask you, I know. Did you carry a firearm?
I did not.
Okay.
I never did. In fact, as a DOD directive, that chaplain is the one career field under no circumstances will ever carry a firearm. I won't even carry an ammo can.
That, see, that's it. I mean, because I'm sure somebody was probably wondering, you know, if you're in Iraq. And aren't you glad you got the service in Iraq? I remember when you were talking about going, I had mixed feelings for you. But you feel so much more like a veteran than had you never did that, don't you?
Oh, absolutely. You know, someday when I'm sitting around the VFW and we're sitting in those war stories.
Right. You've got one. Yeah.
Okay, well, I went to Bermuda. I went to Hawaii.
Right. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's just that it's a much better story to tell.
Everything is a part of the mission. I realize that. But there's nothing like getting that assignment right in the thick of things.
We're going to have some good Memorial Day and Veterans Day shows, Randy McCafferty.
Oh, looking forward to it.
Mac and Norwood, you're on 700 WLW.
How are you doing, guys?
I'm doing great, Mac. So's Randy.
Well, I don't know if it's appropriate to call you a pastor, so...
You can call him pastor.
Pastor's appropriate. Pastor, preacher, chaplain.
By the way, just so you know, Mac, and everybody out there, Randy and I have had discussions, and we don't know what all the future holds of what he might be doing, but Randy... has some very great ideas for starting a church, his own church, and it would be something unlike anything in Greater Cincinnati. So, lot of you people that are listening, you might have an opportunity to come support Randy as he maybe starts a new church. But go ahead, Mac.
I would listen to his message. I would.
He's the best, Mac. I'm telling you, I've listened to a lot of sermons from priests, other pastors, and preachers. And Randy is the best.
Well, I'm not, you got to try it.
Right. And, what do you think of this property tax rollback, Mac?
Well, you guys were on a different subject there, but I just, the bottom line is the homeowners in this county are every time somebody needs a dime or a dollar, they stick it to the homeowners. Now, I want to preface all of this with... I live in an apartment. I've owned homes. Now I choose to live in an apartment. I have no children in school. They're all past that. So I'm not, I don't have a dog in either one of those fights. But I'd be more than willing to pay another quarter cent or a half cent on sales tax to assume a small piece of the burden.
Well, good for you, Mac, and you're a team player. I have news, Mac. I got to roll. 513-749-7000. 513-749-7000. 1-800-THE-BIG-1, #700 on AT&T. When we return, we'll hear from Mike and Dayton, and I'm going to ask Randy McCafferty a tough question. The Bulldog on 700 WLW.